Hello everyone, welcome back to the Python tutorial. In this video, we are going to learn what is tuple, how to create tuple, tuple indexing and splitting, building functions of tuple, and tuple operations. So let's start with the topic. What is tuple? Tuple is a Python data structure. It is called as immutable. What do you mean by immutable? Immutable means the value or the item which we stored inside the tuple cannot be changed. Next is each and every elements which we stored inside the tuple are called as an item. We can define tuple as a collection of values or the items of different types. It means whatever the value we stored inside the tuples can be of different data types. The items in the tuples are separated by the commas and are enclosed within the parentheses. So in short, to create a tuple, we have to use round braces and the elements or the items inside the tuples are separated by the commas. So this was all about the tuple. So let's take an example here. So here we have created a tuple called t1. So for creating a tuple, we are using round brackets and the elements are separated by the commas. So what will happen in the backend? T1 tuple will be created and the memory will be allocated, and all the elements which we have stored inside the tuple are stored in our memory like this: 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60 and 70. Okay, so Now to access these tuples, we require the index number. So the index number always starts with 0. So for the index number for 10 will be 0, then for 20 will be 1, then 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. So these are the index number, and to fetch the particular value from the tuple, we require the index number. So using the index number, we can fetch the values. For example, I want to fetch the value 40. From the tuple t1, so I will write it as t1 in the square bracket 3. So this will give me the output as 40. We are going to see this in practical. Okay, so this is called as forward indexing or forward direction, as our indexing starts from the right. And so if I want to fetch the values from the backward direction, then the index number starts with -1. -2, -3 and goes on. So for example, suppose I want to fetch the value 70 using backward direction, then I will pass the index number as -1. And if I want to fetch the value 70 from the forward direction, then I have to pass the index number as 6. So both will give me the same output. Okay, so this is how we create the tuple and fetch the values using index number. Okay. So now we'll see this practically. Now first we will create a tuple. So tuple name is t1 equals to, inside the round bracket we are going to pass the values m1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Execute it. To print it, we have to just pass the name of the tuple, or you can also use the print function like this, print. And inside the print function, pass the name of the tuple. So this will also give you the same output. So this tuple we have created contains integer value. Next tuple we are going to create, which contains float value like this: 1.2, 3.4, 5.6, and execute it. Print t1. Okay. Now next we are going to create a tuple which will contain multiple values of different data type. So here we'll write it as t1 equals to round bracket. First I'm passing integer value, second I'm passing the string value, and third I will pass the float value, and execute. So here we have created the tuple of different values of different data type. Okay, so this is how we can create a tuple. Okay, now next we are going to see how to fetch the value from the tuples using index number. Okay, so let's create another tuple here. which will contain numbers as 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Okay, execute it, print the tuple, that is t2. Okay, now suppose I want to fetch the value 20 from the tuple. So what is the index number for 20? The index number for 20 is 1. Okay, so we have to pass the index number inside the square bracket and execute. So this will give you the value 20. Now I want to fetch the value 50. So for 50 the index number is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So we will pass the index number as 4. So as I was fetching the values from the forward direction, so I have passed 4. If I am fetching the values from the backward direction, then what will be the index number for 50? It will be the minus 1. So this will also give me the same output. Now suppose I want to fetch the value 40, then I will give the index number as minus 2 and this will give me the output as 40. So this is how we use index numbers to fetch the value from the tuple. Okay, now suppose I want to fetch the value in particular range. For example, I want to fetch the values 20, 30 and 40. Okay, so for that, I have to use the slice operator. So I will write it as t2. Okay, so in the square bracket, we have to use the colon. Okay, now here first value we will pass the start value and second will be your end value. Okay. Fine, so this is your syntax, start and end. So, as I want to start from 20, so what is the index number for 20? It is 1. Then colon. And what is my index number for 40? It is 3. Okay, so I will pass it as 3. Okay, so this is giving me the output as 20 and 30. It is not giving me 40. So, why it is not giving me 40? This is because when we are using slice operator, it will include the start value, but it will exclude the end value. Okay, so if you want 40, then you have to pass the index number of 50, that is 4. So this will give you the value 40. So remember this, whenever you are using slice operator, your first value, that is your start value, is always included, whereas your end value is always excluded. Okay, so this is how we can use slice operator. Next is, suppose I want the values from 20 till end. Okay, so I can just write it as 1 colon and I will not specify the end value because I want all the values from 20. So this will give me output as 20, 30, 40, 50. Okay, now next, if I want to fetch the complete values of the tuple, then you can just pass the colon with you can just pass the colon inside the square bracket. So this will fetch your complete value. Next is, if I want to fetch the value still 40, like from 10 to 40. Okay, I don't want 50. So what I will do? Start value, I will not give any start value. I will just write colon. And what should be my end value? It should be 50. So what is the index number for 50? It is 4. So I will pass it as 4. So this will give me 10, 20, 30, 40. So this is how you can use the slice operator for fetching the values from the tuples. Clear with this? Okay. So next we are going to see some of the built-in functions of tuples. So first function is compare, that is CMP. It compares the two tuples and return true if tuple 1 is greater than tuple 2. Otherwise it will return false. Next function is len function, which is used to calculate the length of the tuple. Second, third, we have max function, which is used to calculate the maximum value from the tuple. And last is mean function, which is used to calculate the minimum value from the tuple. Now let's see these functions practically. Okay, so first we'll see the length of the function. So first we'll print t2. So we have 10, 20, 30, 40 and 50. Now first we'll calculate the length of the function, that is length t2. Execute it. Okay, so it is giving output as 5 because we have only 5 values inside the tuple. Then we can calculate the maximum value. So for that we have max and pass the name of the tuple. So this will give you the output as 50, and for mean it will give you the output as 10. So these were some of the built-in functions of the tuples. Okay, then next we are going to see tuple operations. Okay, so these are the 5 tuple operation. First is repetition. So repetition operator enables the tuple elements to be repeated multiple times. Then we have concatenation. This is used to merge the two different tuples. Then we have membership operator. Membership operator, it will returns true if a particular value exists in the tuple, otherwise it will return false. Then we have iteration operator. In iteration operator, we use for loop, which is used to iterate over the multiple values, or if you want to print the values from the tuple. Okay. And then last we have length, which we have already seen. It is used to calculate the value from the tuple. So these are some of the examples here. Okay. Now we'll see these examples practically. Okay. So first we'll see repetition. So we have T2 tuple. So I want to repeat the values of the tuples 2 times. So I will write it as T2*2. So this will repeat each and every values of the tuples 2 times. See, 10, 10. Then we have 20, 20. Okay. If I want 3 times, then I will write it as 3. So this will repeat the values of the tuples 3 times. Okay. So next operation we have concatenation. So for this we need to create one tuple. So I will create here one tuple as 100, 60. Okay, so I have created one tuple. Now I want to concat both the tuples. So I will just write T2 plus T3. So this will concat my these two tuples. Okay, it will merge the two tuples. Okay, then next we have iteration operator. So for that we have to use for loop. So for I in tuple T2, and then we need to print it. So print I. So this will print the values 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Okay. So what this for loop does is whatever the values are there inside T2, it is copied in our variable I, and then we are just printing the value I. Okay. So for loop. So this is a for loop. This we are going to learn in our next video in detail. Okay. So this is iteration operator. The next is membership operator. It checks whether a particular element is present or not. So for that we are going to see for value 20 in T1, 20 in T2. So 20 is present in T2, so this will give you the boolean value true. Now if I search for 120, as 120 is not present in the tuple T2, so this will give you false. Okay. So these were some of the tuple operations. I hope you have understood the concept. Thank you so much. See you in the next lecture. Don't forget to subscribe and press bell icon for new updated videos. Like and share videos with your friends.